Imagine waking up one morning and deciding, for the next 30 days, I'll eat only fast food. Sounds insane, right? But that's exactly what some daring people and curious scientists have tried. What started as a personal challenge quickly turned into a full-blown experiment that shocked even medical experts. At first, it seems like a dream. No cooking, no dishes, just fries, burgers, and milkshakes. You tell yourself, it's only a month, how bad can it be? But here's where it gets interesting. Your body starts to change within days, and not in the way you might expect. Scientists who've studied similar experiments discovered that your metabolism begins to react almost immediately. The sudden flood of sugar, salt, and fat doesn't just make you feel full, it actually confuses your body's chemical balance. Hormones like insulin and leptin start sending mixed signals, and your energy levels start jumping up and down like a roller coaster. By the end of week one, this fun challenge starts looking more like a scientific warning. And trust me, the real surprises are just beginning. Fast food hits your system fast, literally. Within hours, your blood sugar spikes, and your pancreas rushes to produce insulin to control it. That's when the first wave of fatigue hits. You think the fries gave you energy, but your body's already in overdrive trying to process it all. By day three, digestion starts to slow down. The high fat content in fast food takes longer to break down, leaving you feeling bloated, sluggish, and oddly unsatisfied. It's like your engine is running, but with the wrong kind of fuel. Scientists call this the metabolic confusion phase. Your liver begins storing more fat than usual. Your gut bacteria start to shift, and inflammation slowly builds up. It's subtle. You might not notice it right away, but deep inside, the damage has already begun. If you think this is bad, wait until you find out what your brain does when it realizes it's hooked. Here's the secret most people don't know. Fast food is engineered to make you crave more. Every crunch, every salty bite, every creamy sauce is designed to light up your brain's reward system like a Christmas tree. When you eat a burger, your brain releases dopamine, the same pleasure chemical triggered by addictive substances. Scientists have found the combination of fat, sugar, and salt activates the nucleus accumbens, the brain's pleasure center, making you feel good for a short while and then craving another hit. This explains why you can't stop after just one fry. The brain starts associating fast food with happiness, comfort, and reward, not nutrition. Over time, your dopamine receptors become less sensitive, meaning you need more of that fast food bliss to feel the same satisfaction. And that's how the trap begins. What feels like a guilty pleasure becomes a biological addiction. Fast food can trick you. After eating, you might feel an instant burst of energy. Your brain feels sharper, your mood lifts, and you're ready to take on the day. But it's all an illusion. That energy comes from a quick sugar rush that burns out faster than it arrived. Soon after that, your insulin spikes again and your blood sugar crashes. You feel tired, foggy, and somehow hungry after a full meal. It's your body's way of saying, that wasn't real fuel. The cycle repeats itself every time you eat another fast food meal. Over time, this constant up and down pattern can lead to insulin resistance, one of the first steps toward type 2 diabetes. Your metabolism slows down, your fat storage increases, and your body becomes less efficient at turning food into energy. By day 10, your body's chemistry isn't just reacting, it's adapting, and not in a good way. We often think of fast food as greasy, but the real danger hides in the sugar. Even savory meals, burgers, sauces, buns, are loaded with it. One fast food meal can easily exceed your recommended daily sugar intake without you even realizing it. That excess sugar doesn't just mess with your waistline. It affects your brain, heart, and liver. Your liver starts converting that sugar into fat, which can lead to fatty liver disease, something researchers now call one of the silent killers of modern diets. Meanwhile, your brain becomes dependent on the quick energy sugar provides. You get irritable, tired, and crave more to feel normal. It's a cycle of dependence that mimics addiction patterns seen in drug studies. By the time you hit day 15, sugar has quietly taken control. But that's only half the story, because the real battle is happening inside your organs. By the second week, something invisible begins to happen. While your energy levels crash and your mood swings, your organs are working overtime. The liver, the body's detox powerhouse, starts storing fat rapidly because it can't process all the sugar and grease flooding in. This buildup leads to a condition scientists call non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, and it can happen shockingly fast, sometimes in just 10 days of high-fat meals. The liver becomes inflamed, and enzymes that signal liver stress start to spike. You wouldn't feel pain yet, but under the surface, your body is waving red flags. Meanwhile, your heart faces its own crisis. With every meal, your blood pressure creeps up from excess sodium. The arteries stiffen slightly, and triglycerides, a type of fat in your blood, climb higher. It's not enough to cause a heart attack yet, but it's enough to show how fragile your system becomes. This is where the science gets serious. You might still feel fine, but your blood work would tell a very different story. Fast food doesn't just affect your body, it hijacks your mind. After a few weeks, researchers have found a direct link between high fast food consumption and increased symptoms of anxiety and depression. But why? The reason lies in your gut-brain connection. The gut houses trillions of bacteria that influence mood-regulating chemicals like serotonin. When you eat nutrient-poor fast food, the balance of that microbiome shifts. The good bacteria starve, and the bad ones thrive, sending distress signals to your brain. You begin to feel irritable, tired, and oddly unmotivated. Tasks seem heavier, sleep becomes restless, and your patience disappears faster than your fries. It's not just in your head. It's a biological reaction. By week 3, the experiment feels more like survival. Your body wants nutrients, but your brain keeps whispering, "Just one more burger." You've eaten enough calories for 2 people, yet somehow you still want more. That's the paradox of fast food. It fills your stomach, but starves your cells. The reason lies in the nutrient density, or rather, the lack of it. Fast food is high in energy, but low in fiber, vitamins, and minerals. This imbalance confuses the hunger hormones leptin and ghrelin. Leptin, which tells your brain you're full, stops functioning properly. Ghrelin, the hunger signal, stays active, tricking your body into thinking it needs more food. This is why fast food chains thrive. They sell you the sensation of satisfaction without ever delivering it. It's a clever biological trick that makes overeating almost inevitable. And here's the kicker. Even your stomach starts to expand slightly to accommodate the constant volume of food. It's not just hunger anymore, it's conditioning. By the 3rd week, the changes start showing. Your skin might look oilier due to increased sebum production, driven by hormonal shifts from all that sugar and fat. Acne breakouts become more frequent, and your face can appear puffier due to fluid retention. Weight gain is almost unavoidable at this point. Studies suggest that eating fast food daily can add between 3 to 5 kilograms in a month, depending on your metabolism. But beyond the scale, your posture, energy, and even how you breathe begin to change. Your body adapts to its new diet by slowing down metabolism to conserve energy, a defense mechanism against the erratic spikes and crashes caused by junk food. That's why you start feeling sluggish, even when you're technically eating enough.
And if you're thinking, "I can just burn it off later," the truth might shock you. It takes over 2 hours of jogging to burn off one large combo meal. Somewhere around day 25, the alarm bells get louder. You might feel constant fatigue, headaches, and digestive issues. These are early signs that your body is overwhelmed by inflammation and oxidative stress, the silent forces behind chronic diseases. Doctors who monitored similar 30-day experiments noticed increased cholesterol levels, insulin spikes, and early markers of cardiovascular strain. It's like your body is running a marathon every day, but with no real fuel to sustain it. Even your immune system starts to weaken. Processed foods reduce your body's ability to fight off infection, making you more vulnerable to colds and slower to heal from minor wounds. At this stage, every system, from your heart to your gut, is sending an SOS. The question is, will you listen? If you've made it this far, I've got to ask, would you ever try a 30-day fast food challenge just to see what happens? Tell me in the comments. I'm curious to know if anyone's brave or crazy enough to try it. Day 31 arrives. You wake up and finally skip the drive-thru. No burgers, no soda, no fries. Just a glass of water and a home-cooked meal. At first, it feels strange. Your body has been conditioned to crave that salty, sweet rush, and suddenly, it's gone. But within just a few days, something incredible starts to happen. Your energy begins to stabilize, your digestion improves, and that heavy, bloated feeling slowly disappears. It's as if your body breathes a sigh of relief. Scientists have found that even short breaks from processed food can lower inflammation and restore insulin sensitivity in under a week. Your brain chemistry starts to balance out too. Without constant sugar spikes, your dopamine levels normalize and those roller coaster mood swings begin to fade. You start sleeping better, thinking clearer, and feeling more like yourself again. It's a reminder of how fast the human body can heal, if you give it the right fuel. Experiments like this, from Morgan Spurlock's Supersize Me to recent university-led studies, reveal a fascinating truth. The human body is both incredibly resilient and dangerously adaptable. You can push it hard, but it always keeps score. Scientists analyzing 30-day fast food diets found consistent results: increased cholesterol, liver inflammation, gut microbiome imbalance, and a noticeable decline in mental well-being. Yet they also noticed something else. Once people returned to balanced diets, many markers improved faster than expected. That's the beauty of biology. It fights to survive, but it also remembers. The next time you crave that double cheeseburger, your cells will remember what it cost them last time. This isn't about guilt, it's about awareness. Knowing the science means having the power to choose differently. So what really happens if you eat only fast food for 30 days? The answer goes beyond calories or fat. It's about how modern food is designed, not to nourish you, but to keep you coming back for more. Fast food is a business model disguised as a meal. It hijacks your biology, reshapes your habits, and sells you comfort in exchange for your long-term health. And yet, knowing all this, millions still line up every day because it's fast, cheap, and addictive. But here's the twist. You don't have to give it up forever. The real secret is balance. When you understand what's happening inside your body, one burger won't scare you because you're in control, not the craving. So, if this experiment taught us anything, it's this: the most powerful change begins with awareness, and maybe with your next meal. If this story opened your eyes even a little bit, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. It helps more people understand what their bodies are really telling them. And tell me in the comments, what's your go-to guilty pleasure meal? Let's see how many of us are brave enough to admit it.